Good morning, Gators. I'm Michael.
And I'm Reggie. Welcome back to another edition of Swamp Talk.
Welcome to our first new show of 2021. 2020 was a year to forget, full of history-defining moments that will be remembered forever, especially with COVID and all the political issues.
Agreed, and it doesn't look like it's slowing down yet.
We would like to give a big shout-out to our new Ivy principal, Mr. Jark, for taking over the Ivy program. Attention those interested in softball. An important announcement. Softball tryouts are next Monday the 18th at 10 a.m. and after school on Tuesday the 19th. You must have all athletic paperwork turned in prior to tryouts. If you have any questions, contact Coach Wilkins in room 801.
Students that are currently doing online school, you might know what I'm talking about with this next segment. Or if you ever wonder how students that are at home do work with so many distractions, I know I wouldn't be able to focus. So let's check in with Andrew and Matthew with some ideas on how to manage school while being home.
What's up, Gators? I'm Matthew Moffla.
And I'm Andrew Freire. Now, you guys might be intimidated by the new year, but if you stay motivated, you'll get through it, I promise.
So we thought it'd be helpful to give you guys 5 useful tips on how to stay motivated during this school year.
Number 1, sleep. Stop going to bed at 2 a.m. when you have school at 7. Why do you think you're always cranky when you wake up? Get more sleep and you'll start seeing changes in mood fast.
Next thing, time management. Make sure you at least write down your assignments so there's more of a chance you're going to be able to do them.
Number 3, health is wealth. If you eat good, healthy foods, you'll expend good energy. And guess what you can use that quality energy for? The gym. This step is probably one of the most important changes you can make to improve your physical and mental state.
Number 4, how about you go out and find some hobbies that will keep you healthy?
And finally, number 5, make a TikTok. Now I know what you're thinking. How is making a TikTok going to keep me motivated? Well, just watch and learn.
What are they talking about? What are the folks talking about? Huh? Look, buddy gonna get that, get that, get that, get that. Send shots, make him get back. All that chit chat, chit chat, riff rap, my they into that.
No, but in all seriousness, just get off of TikTok and do your work. You'll thank us later.
Those sound like some pretty good ideas. Thanks, guys.
Girls Across has conditioning sessions Mondays and Fridays from 2:30 to 3:30 from January 22nd. Make sure you bring water and good running shoes.
Tennis tryouts will be on January 19th and 20th. Make sure to have all the required paperwork with you.
The girls begin at 2:30 on Thursdays the 19th, and the boys begin at 3:45. The times were switched on Friday.
Attention students, if you are interested in track, there is a meeting tomorrow after school on the bleachers by the track.
Now to Cole Russell for some national news.
Good morning, good afternoon, and or good evening, Gators. Let's move on to the news around the nation. Elon Musk recently surpassed Jeff Bezos as the wealthiest man in the world. Bezos has held this title since 2017, and Musk's wealth surge over the past few years marks a dramatic financial turnaround for the famed entrepreneur. Multiple COVID-19 vaccines are currently available or will be available soon. These include the Moderna vaccine, Pfizer vaccine, which is known to kill even the mutated strains in South Africa and the UK, and the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, which only requires a single dose to be effective rather than the standard 2. Lastly for today, President Trump acknowledges and accepts Biden's victory in the 2020 presidential election and plans to seamlessly and smoothly transition power to the, quote, new administration. Trump had vowed to never give in to Biden. So this sparked the storming of the Capitol building last week, after which Trump condemned the actions of his supporters. That's all we have for this week. Have a nice day, and stay safe.
Now let's go to Owen for a question of the week.
All right, if you could add any restaurant to campus, what restaurant would it be?
Ooh, Popeyes, easily.
Okay. If you could add any restaurant on campus, which restaurant would you want it to be?
It's a tough choice. That'd probably have to be, I said Chick-fil-A because, yeah, it's chicken, but it's like sort of a healthier kind of chicken.
If you could add one restaurant on campus, what would it be?
Chick-fil-A.
Okay, I'm here with Aiden at lunch. Aiden, if there was one restaurant you want added to campus, what restaurant would you pick?
Chick-fil-A, easy, no doubt.
I'm here with PK. PK, if you could add any restaurant to the school campus, which restaurant would you pick?
Chick-fil-A.
At lunch, Larissa, if you could build any type of restaurant on the campus, which would it be?
I'd probably say Cheddar's.
At lunch, Caleb, if you could add any restaurant to school campus, which restaurant would you want it to be?
Chipotle.
Thanks, Owen. That's all for today. Tune in Friday for your next edition of Swamp Talk.
Have a great day, Gators.